Friday morning, getting ready to head out for another day. We stayed to Hampton's Inn and Suites. And this is at Staunton, Massachusetts. It's S-T-O-U-G-H-T-O-N. Maybe pronouncing that right. So getting ready to head out for another day. Friday morning, heading out towards Boston. A little bit of rain, just a mist. Nothing heavy yet. Maybe it'll stay that
Take
way.
A slight right turn.
So we should be in Boston in 40 to 45 minutes. There's a city in front of us, but it's really foggy. You can probably see some of the buildings there as we get closer. You see shadows of them there. Okay, after touring Fenway Park, we're going to go eat here at the original Tasty. Probably here at the parking lot. I said they used to be over here to the left, and they're redeveloping all that area, tearing stuff down, so they located over here. He says it's good food. After our tour of Fenway Park, now we're going to the JFK Museum and Library. Still maneuvering through Boston. Rita's doing a good job. Look at all this traffic. So there's the JFK Library. That's our next destination. And we're not far away. We're only two and a half miles, and it says 10 minutes. So that's how fast the traffic's moving. This is outside of the John F. Kennedy Museum and Library. This is called Revere Beach. And this is outside of Boston. We're heading towards Salem. It's a long beach. Hesitant to start recording, but I think we're going to make it over the bridge this time.
That's a pretty bridge over here to the left, too. Yep.
This is a drawbridge that we're going over, and there's another bridge over there.
They're still backed up over there, too, Daryl.
Oh, yeah.
We don't know if the accident was on our side or I-95 side.
Yeah, the New Hampshire Service, or the New Hampshire Welcome Center guys told me that there had been an accident on I-95. That may be why that's all backed up over there. But we're on another road. We're on one north.
And it's a drawbridge.
10 minutes to the motel, and we're 2 miles away. That's how fast we're moving. We're moving really fast now compared to what we've been doing. But anyway, this is a drawbridge that we're going to go over.
There's the ambulance over there on the bridge. I can see flashing lights.
Yeah. That guy was right. Of course, there's more water down there. Lots of cranes over there, so we don't know if that's a shipping port where packages, where boats come in. I don't know. Or maybe they're building something. There's a lot of cranes, though. Right over there. Well, we're back out over the bridge, and it's starting to thin out now, so maybe we can get going. Welcome to historic Kittery. Kittery, and we know it's in Maine, so Maine's first town. I think that's what that says, yeah. 1647. Saturday the 24th. This is day 8. And we're going to be heading towards Niagara Falls. And we're going to try to go through Vermont. And that will be the last state up here in the Northeast that we haven't been through. So we'll be on our way. Here's our route today to get to Vermont. We stayed in Kittery, Maine last night. And we came up through here. And we're around this area right now. So we kind of went north and then now we're going back west. Here's the first town in Vermont. Brattleboro. So we're right in here. There's Brattleboro. Not too far from Vermont, and rain's picking up. Still not real heavy, but it's enough to keep the wipers on constantly. 10 miles from Vermont. Well, the directions say Vermont 9 is what we're on now, so we're not sure if we're already in Vermont or it'll be shortly. This is Brattleboro, and our next destination is Niagara Falls, so we're punched in on the maps and we're heading that direction. Won't get there today, but we'll get there in, it says roughly 6 hours, so be there by tomorrow. Yeah, Brattleboro Tire. That proves we're in Brattleboro. We're going over mountains, and Rita said we went up more than we went down, so I guess we're still climbing in elevation. This is out of Brattleboro, Vermont, and we're heading southwest. We went through Marlboro after Brattleboro, and now we're on this road for 24 more miles. This is 9. Vermont 9 East.
Scenic overlook. Let's stop.
All right.
Before the U-turn here.
Hogback Mountain Gift Shop. So we gotta go check this out, okay?
Okay.
All right, this is Hogback Mountain. Stopped here at this country store.
Home of maple creamy ice cream.
Yeah, we got some of that. And we bought some more souvenirs. And I'd say this is a great view when it's not foggy like today, but Still pretty nice. This is Wilmington, Vermont. Still on 9 East. Looks like a downtown.
There was a church on the left. Might still be a church. Couldn't tell the name on it.
I think it said St. Mary's. Wilmington, Vermont.
Cask and Kiln over on the right is what it says above the windows. Dot's Restaurant down here on the right.
The next 3 miles is supposed to be Winding Hill. Unsafe to pass. So Rita's downshifted. Try to keep hitting the brakes so much. And she's doing 45 now.
Picking up speed.
Got a runaway truck ramp in a mile. We're now in New York.
For 25 miles, continue straight.
Been in New York for a mile or so. Long drive across this state to go to Niagara Falls. We're in Troy, New York.
There was a motorcycle rider back there in the rain. Big sign of Troy here.
There's Troy. Welcome to the home of Uncle Sam. All right, ate lunch at Troy, New York at McDonald's. Just wanted to get something quick around 1 o'clock. Managed to find a room to stay tonight and possibly order some local pizza from someplace if we can find some. Well, we hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, how about giving us a like and subscribing to our channel? Thanks.